Hello everyone, my name is JMLisondra and today I'm going to teach you how to paint this wonderful landscape painting. So today my subject will be this window on the side of the house. Okay, and please don't forget to subscribe. You will subscribe it and hit the bell button if you want to receive some future notifications on my new videos and tutorials. Okay, you can see all the materials needed on the screen. You can see there the 5 limited colors, the brushes that we're going to need and all the things that we're going to need to paint this painting. Okay, so I'm going to start now and I'm gonna do the underpainting first. So we have the sketch, the first step, and then the second step will be the underpainting. Okay, so let's start. I'll be using a bigger flat brush. I have here the 1.5 inch flat brush. Okay, still wet. I have to clean the brush first, everyone. Going to use the yellow and the blue to make some greens. I'm going to add first those parts which I'm gonna put my plants. Okay, so here I'm gonna put plants here and also here. It will cover a little bit. Then also here. Yeah, let's put some plants here on the plant box. Okay, so this part will be the plants. So I am going to add some raw umber and then white. My white is so fluid, everyone. I forgot to remove the water. So here. Yeah, at first some other paintings. So create some textures there. Do not make it so plain, like what I'm doing here now. Because this concrete house, everyone. I just want to create textures on this house. Just use the raw umber with a bit of white and it's enough for that one. It's okay if you cover some parts, it's fine. Mm-hmm. Okay. There. On the back right, I'm gonna put a little bit of also like this color. Like there's also another house there, concrete house. There, okay. This is a plant box here. Okay, so I'm gonna need some greens. Yeah, well, this green, I'm gonna put some amber to make it dark. Some yellow. Okay, it's okay. Blue and the red. Okay, I can add some trees also in the background, but I want it to be a little bit faded, everyone, something like that. There. Also here, let's add some darks. So I need to add the underpainting first before I'm gonna start adding those beautiful details. I need also to put some blue and the white. Yeah, for the sky, everyone. Add some white. Yeah. And then only use a little bit other medium size flat brush now because some parts are too small, okay? So I'm gonna mix for an orange, red, and then yellow. A little bit of amber, white. This is an orange roof. Do not make it so clean, everyone. I'm going to add some amber. Okay, I'm gonna put some yellow and then white to create details. Anyway, some parts will be covered, so I do not need to make it so good. Okay. And then I'm gonna use some white with this light color, yellowish. Let's try to add some details here, lights. I'm going to add some windows. Okay. We'll put a little bit of gutter here. There. So we have now another building on the background. So I don't want to focus on that part, everyone. Just make it like a little bit abstract. You do not need to make it so clear and clean. Okay, doesn't have to be like that, because later on I'll just cover that part with the tree here on the side. So yeah, it will not matter anymore. You can add just a bit of details or design on that, on the windows. Just like that one, just cross design, okay? And then let's cover this part here. I want to create a little bit purple color. Sorry, it should be darker, I think. Blue and the red. I think we'll make it lighter. Blue and the red, and then white, make it a bit lighter. This is a glass window, everyone. Okay, and then you can put some raw amber here, dark raw amber. This is a flower base, everyone. Actually, I will put two flower base here. Some dark here because this part should be cast, have casted shadow. There. So we have now done the painting. Okay. Actually, it's clear now. One more thing. Okay, so I'm going to use this raw amber. going to add some perspective here. A little bit border. Okay, still wet. There, okay, and then I'll put some lines also here. And then we can also put some bluish green on the but dark everyone on the window everyone to show that there's some trees there, something like that. So yeah, and even here some reflection of this, which should be dark. And also here. Actually, these are the reflection of the trees in the background, everyone. Since this window is tinted, usually the reflection will be really dark. Okay, that's what I observe, but I don't know, I don't really know, I'm not perfect. So yeah, okay, there, can darken also here. And then we can start by adding some light color. I want it a little bit yellowish, everyone, for the window here. just like that. Okay, just a few lines. There. Okay, that looks good, like that. Yeah. And then everyone, I'm going to add some light here, here, but some parts will be covered by some leaves, something like that. Okay. So I'll be using a bigger brush, this one. So I have here the white, and I'm gonna put a little bit yellow and red to make it light orange. Maybe I will start now putting using the palette knife. Okay. My water, my white is so fluid, everyone, because I put there's a water in there. There. I like how the white will interact everyone because I want it to be so contrasting. Okay. Yeah, sorry about that part. I cannot see it, but it's okay. I'll just try to add more. Okay, yeah, maybe I will try now to refine the habit. I have to support something here. Okay. Okay. I'm going to use a bristle flat brush, everyone, for the plants here. So I'm gonna use this bristle flat brush number 9, medium size flat brush, medium size white bristle flat brush. So red, I know, yellow and the blue. Put some red and then blue and then yellow. Just stopping technique, everyone. Like that. There. Okay. Yeah. I'm gonna put a little bit yellowish to create highlights. The light's coming from the left side again. Okay. And then we will put some colors on the base. So red, I'm gonna use some red and then amber and then yellow. Yeah, it should be a brownish color if you want. And a little bit of white, a little amber. Okay, next we can start adding now some red. Okay, so because these are flowers, add more red, add a lot of red. Just do the tapping technique, everyone. Okay. And then we can use now the red and the white, or what we call pink. There. Just fill this part with flowers. I'm going to put some white to make it pink. Just do it one by one, like that. So we have now some flowers on the, I like that, everyone, it's so good. On this window, and it looks really, really nice. I like it. It looks clean and good. Okay, so I have to refine, everyone, the walls there. I have to make it look good and realistic. Even like that, it looks so good. Looks like a wall. Okay, like a wall. Okay, I will use a bigger brush. I'm gonna put a little bit reddish purple on the wall, everyone. Those casted shadow there. So blue and the red. And then white. That's too much dark. Add more white. There. And a bit here. This should be a casted shadow here. Gonna put a little bit of umber. A shadow there. Yeah, colors a little bit purples. I'm sorry, everyone. I don't want to even say on the bottom part, sorry. And then I'm gonna mix for raw umber and the yellow and then white. I'm gonna put it a little bit of red also. More white. And this one, because this shadow will be on the bottom. I know you didn't see this part one, sorry. That's off canvas, sorry. I'll show you everything there later on. Okay, so we can see now that the light is spreading really, really nice. Yeah, I like it. Yeah, I think I also need to put it here. Okay, that's good. Yeah, as you can see, it looks free. It's good. It looks good and pretty realistic. Okay. So I don't know. Maybe I'm going to enhance the color of the pink here. So I'm gonna need a clean brush. Okay, so I'm gonna need this brush, everyone. I'm gonna need a clean red and a white. Maybe a little bit of yellow. Like that. Just use the tapping technique. You kinda need to use a very clean color. It should be a highly contrasting color, everyone. I just want to try to do like that. Okay. Maybe I can try a little bit of yellow. Okay, for now, that'll be enough. Yeah, so far I love it. the background, everyone, I don't want to make it so much clear. I just want to do like that, like a little bit of abstract or impressionistic, because I'll just cover it some parts. So I'll try to put 1-3 there. I think it will be good adding some 3 there, and some also flowers and plants on the bottom side. So yeah, I do like that. Okay, so let's start it with the tree. Okay. So I'm gonna put a big tree here, right on the side. I have here the raw umber. I'm going to add a little bit of white on this so that I don't want to make it so bright. With a little bit of blue. Yeah. This will be an old tree. There. White and raw umber. Okay, I'll be using the smaller flat brush. Okay, I'm going to add now some leaves. So yellow, red, and the green. Or yellow, red, and the blue. I mean, little bit of white. Okay. Just use the brush, this brush, everyone, make the leaves one by one. These trees have really big leaves. Okay. Yeah, that tree there is so simple and it's a little bit off light. Okay, that's why all our eyes is on the window, everyone. So that's the main point there. And then we can start adding some greenish light, blue and the yellow, and then I'm going to put a little bit of white. Okay. And then I will start putting the white flower. Need to add some white. Look like a color tutti plant, everyone. There, okay. Yeah, and the color is a little bit off. I mean, there's no light hitting on that part, and I like that way for now because I don't want to spoil that part and make it. I don't want. I want every back, everything in the background off, everyone. Meaning, I don't want it to be. To give attraction. Okay, so I just want it to be really off. Okay, let's start to add some plants here, and okay, I will try to add yellow and white, a little bit of red. Blue umber, white. This plant box, everyone. Just want to analyze something. It's hard to add here because I have no space. Okay, and using this, okay, so yeah, and then I'm going to add those. Oh, wait, I'm going to add some more lights here. This is a plant box, everyone. There, and then let's add some darks. Okay, I'm going to add some raw umber. I'm going to use this bristle flat brush. So I have here the blue and the yellow, and then the red. Can also use a little bit for ombre ground to make some parts dark. Yeah, okay. Yeah, looks like there's also plants there. And then I'm gonna use this small this brush, everyone. I'm gonna do it one by one. First, I'm gonna use some green, yellow, and the blue, and the red, and the amber, and then some white. Some more yellow. Okay, you can use to add more plants. Using the small flat brush. There. Actually, you can create different kind of plants, everyone. It's up to you. Yeah. Yeah, so it becoming good on that part. I like that. So it should you should make it all busy, everyone. Like there's a lot of things there. So I'm gonna put some white. Okay. Yeah, okay. Some yellowish color here to make it so attractive and light. Can use even yellowish with white. Yeah. Okay, that's a lot of plants. Yeah, and I like it, everyone. It looks so simple and yeah, it's so good. Okay, we can add more that it will make the entire place busy, everyone, and Gio take something like that, something like didn't clean it at all, those plants there. So I like that. I'm gonna put some white. Then let's put some flowers also, maybe an orange flower. Yellow and the red. Put some more yellow. Okay, and then some maybe we can put some white, something like that. Yeah. Also put some red here. Okay, and over here. And also put some white, maybe here, and put some white. Okay. Yeah, I like it, everyone. It's just too simple and it's really attractive for me. I'm going to add some more white, maybe some more yellow. So some yellow here. I'll just make everything very contrast, everyone. There. So at least it looks so good there, that part. Looks like that there's a lot of things there. A lot of trees, lot of plants. So here I will also put, I'll be using this also put some tree trunk, okay. blue, yellow, and then amber. So be darker for one. Can add some light green. Okay, so I am now in the process of retouching. Okay, how about this? Yeah, so I think that will be enough for now, everyone. I think that will be perfect for this tutorial. It's not doesn't have to be I'm very contented. The details is good, a lot of details, you can see a lot of things there. My message is just very simple: to paint a house with the window of a house with a lot of plants there. So that's what I just want to show you, and I hope that you learn from this tutorial. You can also paint by yourself. You can paint like this, you can add anything there, you can enhance this painting as you want.
Okay everyone, so I want to say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praise always belongs to the Lord.